In Miami today, after 14 cases of Zika thought to be homegrown were found in 1 square mile of the city. We do have team coverage for you. Robbie Owens is in North Dallas sharing what local health officials are doing to keep North Texans safe. But we begin in Miami with CBS's Weisha Zhang.
Kaylee, we are actually standing in the heart of the part of the city that is considered the Zika zone. It's believed to be the first place that the CDC has ever warned people not to go to in the U.S. in the agency's 70-year history. Now, inspectors are aggressively spraying this area, but it looks like the mosquito carrying Zika might be resistant to the insecticide. In fact, its nickname is Little Ninja because it can hide almost anywhere.
Jessica Ardente is 4 months pregnant. The 36-year-old is getting tested for Zika because she lives in the 1 square mile of Miami where health officials say local mosquitoes are now spreading the virus.
Women are scared to death right now because we try to do whatever we can to maintain safety during pregnancy. We take care of our bodies, our diet, exercise activity, and now we have to worry about the mosquitoes.
Zika can cause devastating birth defects, including microcephaly, which leaves babies with unusually small heads. Ardente is doing the best she can to prevent mosquito bites.
I really don't have much of a choice right now, so I'm just going to kind of hunker down.
Nurses are distributing prevention kits to pregnant women in Miami that include insect repellent and condoms because the virus can also be sexually transmitted.
The CDC says any pregnant women who visited this neighborhood north of downtown Miami since mid-June should be tested for Zika.
University of Miami doctor Christine Curry has treated about a dozen pregnant women with travel-related Zika.
If I have a mom, then I'm worried about microcephaly while she's still pregnant. Obviously, I need to be honest with her about the diagnosis and the potential that it's real.
Health experts say it's up to everyone to protect themselves from mosquito bites to stop the virus from spreading.
And the city of Miami has added extra street sweeping routes to get rid of any litter and added crews to look for standing water because that is where the mosquito can breed. On top of that, the CDC will continue aerial sprays of the area. But remember, it seems to be not as powerful as they hoped for, and it's not so easy to just replace it with a new insecticide because of environmental regulations. Gilma and Kaylee?
Weisha, a quick question for you. We know that there are concerns really across the board. People there are talking about concerns with this virus possibly spreading to other places like Dallas-Fort Worth. Can you talk a little more about that?
Yeah, you know, that doctor that you just met in our piece, Dr. Curry, told us today that transmission is a two-way street. And that means, let's say someone here in Miami who has Zika goes to Dallas, and then a mosquito there bites that person. Well, then, if that mosquito bites people in Dallas, there you go. That's how it begins to spread in other parts of the country and why doctors say it's so critical right now for people to take preventative measures.
Weisha Zhang reporting live for us out of Miami. Thank you very much.
Today, the CDC announced it's giving Texas $750,000 to help the state quickly identify babies who may have serious birth defects linked to Zika. CBS 11's Robbie Owens is live in North Dallas to show us how the crisis in Miami is being felt here. Robbie.
Well, Gilma, Dallas County is already monitoring about a dozen women who may have been exposed to Zika while traveling, pregnant women. But they stressed today that none of their tests have shown that the virus is present in mosquitoes here right now. But they also know that that will change. So during a morning briefing at the Dallas County Commissioner's Court, local officials told them that they are closely watching this Zika crisis just north of Miami. They've been in contact with colleagues there, and they're looking to learn all they can as they also look to adjust their procedures here. They tell me that they're particularly concerned that the mosquitoes are proving resistant to the pesticide.
It's been referred to as the cockroach of mosquitoes. It lives indoors and outdoors. It can breed or hatch in a few drops of water. The eggs can last for months, and it can bite 4 or 5 people at once, so it spreads the disease rapidly.
Local officials, meanwhile, are managing their message. They say they don't want to push the panic button, but at the same time, they also need North Texans to take this disease seriously. They continue to stress that prevention message, and ahead at 5, a message for would-be travelers. Reporting live in North Dallas, Robbie Owens, CBS.